Call on the Honourable Mr Sims.
Thank you, Acting President. I move that the report of the Select Committee on the Privatisation of Public Services in South Australia be noted.
Second. I put the question for the question. Oh. Moved it. Go on.
Thank you, Acting Chair. Very briefly, the Privatisation Committee was established back in May and has handed down its report earlier this week. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the members of the committee for their efforts. The Honourable John Daly, the Honourable Heidi Girolamo, the Honourable Frank Pangello, the Honourable Irene Nevmatikos, and I also acknowledge the contribution of the former member, the Honourable David Ridgway, who departed the committee in June. And I acknowledge the work of Leslie Guy in the Secretariat, and I want to thank her for all of her efforts in ensuring that the committee ran so smoothly and that we were able to provide a timely report to this chamber. In terms of a brief summary, Mr President, we received 22 submissions and there were 6 public hearings. The committee heard a range of evidence. In particular, it is clear that privatisation has had adverse impacts on services here in South Australia and also on the experience of many staff working in public services that have been privatised. The report made a range of recommendations for the future that would improve the accountability of private corporations that run public services and safeguard them against the sell-offs of our public services without due consideration of the impact. And in terms of some of the key recommendations from the majority report, these include the establishment of an independent regulatory body to provide oversight over services that have been privatised, the establishment of a standing parliamentary committee to review existing privatisations and make recommendations on any proposed privatisations prior to government approval, subsidies of subsidiaries rather of multinationals awarded contracts for delivering public services to publicly report on their domestic and international revenues and tax payments, protections of employment standards for those working in government services that are privatised, and a moratorium on further privatisations on government services until all recommendations are actioned. And that's just a snapshot of the recommendations. There were 13 recommendations in total, Chair, President, and I certainly think that if these were implemented, they would greatly improve the transparency around privatisations here in our state. And with that, I conclude my remarks.